I have some good news. Popcorn is in the building. Yeah, go on. All right, ladies and gentlemen, as promised, we are about to have a conversation with the brother Popcorn. We're going to start from the early days up until now. As you know, new album, new project dropping tonight at midnight. So tonight is a celebratory night, and we get to do that with him. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise and welcome to the stage, Popcorn.
Ninja and get pussy seeing there. That's
easy. Fanatics.
Well, G-Wagon Jeep. Like pussy girl on the front seat. Give them help on the air like map deep. Pussy them girls so we fun sweet. Oh, skeleton cartier. Tell them some richer than last year. Fresh Louis.
Rip.
Girl, I say me skin pretty than a bike flare. So mommy dogs, they got them for the right here. Become my dog, grandma frying.
That is it, though. All right. Well, welcome.
Well,
yeah.
Blessings. Good night, everybody. My name is Andre Sutherland, aka Popcorn the Unruly Boss, the 876. And it's a blessing seeing everyone tonight. I appreciate you for pulling up. Even though I'm late, it's going to be great.
All right. So where I wanted to start the conversation, just so you know, before you got here, I let them know that what we're about to do, this conversation, is not something that you could Google or YouTube, because this is just two brethren's reasoning, talking and discussing the journey with gratitude and with enthusiasm, because the journey's been great, and great is he, and great is to forward.
That is it.
That is it. I don't know if you guys are excited, but I am. All right. So there's a question that we've seen in movies, we've seen in TV, and it's usually pertaining to hip hop. And some of you will say, when did you fall in love with hip hop? So for you, I'm going to ask you, when did you fall in love with dancehall? When did you know that you could be an artist? I'm talking about from the very first, the early out.
Well, with me, it was a bit of mixture with church and dancehall, because I grew with my grandmother. So while growing up with grandma, I wasn't raised by Miss Rona. I was raised by my grandma, Gwyneth Sutherland. So while growing up with grandma, she's the pastor for the church and things. So she don't like when I listen to certain music, so I actually have to hide and listen to dancehall music.
Right.
When she gonna market her, when she's not around, you know? She more want me to listen to gospel music, but I'm always intrigued by dancehall music from a tender age. And I used to sing in the choir, so I was already born with a musical talent, you know? So while going to church with grandma sometime, when they have party, I used to hide and go to the parties and thing. But when grandma find out, it's a madness. But I do it repeatedly same way because of the love for the music, you know? Right. And then grandma got me this keyboard while I was young. So I started learning to play the keyboard on my own, you know? And by playing that keyboard, I started to write my own lyrics, you know, and I used to go to school and keep concert during lunchtime, you know, when teacher was ready to go to class after lunchtime, the whole corridor packed with students, you know, we keep in live stage show and knocking the decks and things. So with all that, the church and dancehall music is what curve my talent to this day, you know what I'm saying?
Wow.
Yeah.
How many of you guys knew that about Popcorn's connection to the church? Not too many. Yeah. So thanks for sharing that.
Yeah.
I have a similar similar brought up, so you have a similar story hiding to listen to hip-hop music because I want to listen to when they're cursing and all that, and my mom and them saying, nah, none of that in this house. We are Christian.
Trouble,
foot, feet. But as you say, there's a certain love for it. At what point did you realize, because you said you got the keyboard, you were singing, and you're making the lyrics, and then you know, obviously the school hallways is where a lot of artists really start to hone their craft. At what point did you realize, you know, this is something that I want to do professionally? And did you have any mentors? You know, because what we're doing right now is having a conversation in front of a bunch of young people, lots of talent in this room. So I'm trying to make that connection to those early days for you.
Well, I mean, I always dream big from when I was small, so I always think that I would be this big artist, you know? Mm. So I was very optimistic about it from even when I was in church, because we used to do like drama thing in church, same way where we do like Jamaican plays, you know? You know, like something similar to like Third World Cup and those things, but yeah, the church version, you know what I mean?
Okay.
So my grandma write like little scripts and I would like perform them in church. So I was already a performer from a tender age as well, you know? So like when I started to go to Portmore now, and I was closer to Vibes Cartel, because Vibes Cartel is from Portmore, you know. So while I was doing music there, well, I wasn't even thinking that I would meet Vibes Cartel. I was like, just a fan, you know.
Right.
So I went to do a test to go in the army. You know, I wanted to be a soldier.
Wow.
In the Jamaica Army. So when I went to do that test and I sat you there, in Portmore, somehow I failed the test, you know, because that wasn't my destiny.
You said somehow.
Yeah. But I'm glad I failed that test, actually.
True. Listen, it's always God's plan over your plan, though.
And I was so disappointed too, and I was like, yo, not even want to be a soldier, man. They diss me today.
Yeah.
So now it made me like start think a lot of different things, you know, a lot of different ways how to make money now. And I was like, I need to do music. And then I had this friend, his name is Bama Terror. I have his name tattooed right there. Police kill him like a few months after I did this army test. So now it was a lot of pressure, you know. So I was like, trying to find a way out to make money. So I started to record music with my brother in Portmore. And then after that, I met Not Nice, you know. I was walking through the scheme, singing. Whichever small stage show I run, I would go there and I would just walk and follow the music and just go there and perform, you know what I mean? Like, it was like rehearsal. So then I went to one of these stage shows and I met Not Nice. Well, he heard me singing and I was like, yo, that youth sound bad. So then he asked somebody like, who is that youth? And they introduced me to him and thing. And I went to Not Nice studio and then I recorded a song called Gyal Wine. That was the first song I recorded professionally, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And then I went to this party after, called My Scheme. And Vibes Cartel was the special guest at that concert, you know. But it was a party, but they had like special guests. So.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, as me tell you before, Vibes Cartel is like wide all and them thing. You know, every youth at Portmore love Vibes Cartel music, you see me? So right there and then now, I was like, yo, I have to be here tonight. I was telling all my friends, you know, yo, I'm going to roll out tonight. But I wasn't thinking to perform or anything. And when we went there now, was just there watching, and then like people start fighting, you know, and people run left, people run right, people run all over. So I thought the party finished, but when we was leaving, now we see Vibes Cartel like right where we at. He left the stage. So yo, I just went there and was telling him, yo, we from this scheme and we rate the music and them shit there. And he saw that it was a lot of us there. You know, and we walk with him, go to the stage again, and him say, yo, oh, me for leave the scheme and my scheme, and him start singing, and then everybody running at the venue again, you see me? So me I tell my friend them say, yo, this is my time to DJ now, bro. So I went and I tell him I want to sing a song. And he say, yo, sing a song. So I sing a song and the people them love it. And him say, me if you sing a next song, I'm sing a next song and the people them love the next one I'm sing. So it was like, don't move. And then him finished perform. And then he gave me his number, you know, and that's where everything started, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. What?
So big up Vibes Cartel, freedom, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, man.
Now, see, that story, there's a number of reasons why that story is significant. It's significant because, obviously, Vibes Cartel at the time, he knew that his influence, his cosign, what that could do for a young artist in his scheme at that. But then also, you know, it's one of the first times where internationally you hear, when you hear, you remember here, you're hearing Vibes Cartel saying, Wagwan Popcorn. Like, who has not said Wagwan Popcorn? That right there was a big cosign.
100%.
100%. And that could change the trajectory of someone's life. But there's a couple of things from that story he just shared that are significant. Working with a producer, not nice. You know, when you're working with producers nowadays, you know, what is it that you're looking for?
Me, I'm just looking for hit music, bro.
Straight.
Yeah, that's all.
Straight.
There's nothing else to look for more than hit music, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
But the way I make music, bro, is like I'm a part of everything. You know what I'm saying? I'll tell a producer how I want him to make this rhythm.
Right.
And what I need it to sound like. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, When I'm making music, I'm very open, you know what I'm saying, to like try different vibe and thing, you know what I'm saying? Right. Yeah.
I don't want to jump to the collaborations just yet, because obviously At Midnight is a special new project that's dropping for you. But before we go there, I wanted to ask you about anybody here follow Popcorn on Instagram? All right. So when you follow Popcorn on Instagram, there's gonna be certain things that you get to learn about his personality. Somebody already said one of my favorite things to see on his Instagram, as somebody that's grown up by yard people, is Miss Rona. That is one of my favorite things that I could possibly see, because you can just tell the love, the respect that is there.
Yeah.
If you would be so kind, briefly just talk about, you know, the relationship with her. Almost troubling her.
Miss Rona, I'm alive, man. You can't see that. Yeah, we got Miss Rona. Anyway, she there. She probably a pray right now.
Yeah.
What's the time? She probably a pray for me and you right now, T-Rex.
And
I ask God for protect we and bless we and continue to keep we alive and well, you know what I'm saying?
But the man can pray, though. Yeah, hear it.
Oh, me? Of course I can.
Yeah.
I'm a God-fearing person. I was raised that way, you know what I'm saying? So even though I'm the unruly boss, you know, me still have to follow protocol and have the morals that I was raised with, you know what I'm saying?
For sure.
That is it.
Yeah. And that's, you know what, I think when you guys have the chance to listen to the album, you know, it's not just the title, Great Is He. When you see the title, Great Is He, you might think, okay, there's some connection here. the reference you just made, you know, growing up in the church. But there is protocol. There is guidelines.
100%.
So let's talk about Greatest Heat, because that is the next project. And how did you land with the name?
Well, I had the song before, and I was searching for names for the album. And one day Ricky called me and asked me what I think about the name Great Is He. Mm. And I was like, Great Is Me. So that's the name of it, you know?
That is it.
And I really love that song too, you know? It's a song that I sing to strengthen people and encourage them to stay strong, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Because with my experience, even though a lot of people might think like, because of fame and money, we always have life smooth. Life is not always smooth for us, you know? And that is why I try to show people that in my music, that they don't really get delusional about life and think that if you have a million tomorrow, it's the end of the world and life is just gonna be milk and honey. Life is never milk and honey for no one, you know? So that's why I sing those music to give people that strength within themselves and motivate them, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Yeah, bro.
Let's talk about some of the collabs on that.
Yeah.
So, Chronic Law, the hook on that one is, you know, starting from zero, but look for me now.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean?
I'm a example and a motivation to the youths of St. Thomas. And, you know, St. Thomas is like the worst part in Jamaica from growing up to this day, you know. It's just starting to develop a little bit. So I have to, like, encourage as much youth as I can in St. Thomas to, like, do what they can to make it out and invest in St. Thomas, you know, because a youth like Chronic Law is very talented, is very promising, you know? And I'm glad that we are able to do this as St. Thomas natives, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, because a lot of youths in Jamaica, like where they're from, they are like enemies, you know? So it's good that me and Chronic Law can unite and do that for our parish, you know what I'm saying?
For sure.
Yeah.
I mean, listen, we see, and you just gave that respect to Cartel for, you know, bringing you on the stage that night, and how much that changed your life. So even seeing a song, and the song is wicked, 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 but the song with Chronic Law now, you know, maybe that's the forward that he needs as well.
Of course.
Mad.
Yeah, of course.
All right. The other thing, not to make this interview structured by Instagram, but the other thing that you'll notice if you follow Poppy is his love for cars, bikes. Mm-hmm. If you have to pick between the cars and the bikes, which one is it?
Bike life, you know.
Yeah. Banging. Yeah. So, and then if you have to pick between the bikes and the Abu Buya, which one do you pick though?
Well, it's a bike, so.
It's a bike,
same place. In the same place.
All right, yeah. So let's talk about that then. So you guys know what I'm talking about when I say the Abu Buya? Am I saying it right?
Mm-hmm.
Something like that, though.
You have to Google it. It's a bike in Africa.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So the Abu Buya now.
Yeah, let me have to ride the Abu Buya, you know. No man ban the Abu Buya, you know.
Trouble.
Yeah. That is it.
That is it. The thing that I loved the most on those visuals recently was yours was a Gucci Abu Buya.
Yeah.
Mad.
Custom Abu Buya.
Abu Buya. Sorry, I'm saying it wrong. So, anyways, working with Burna Boy and, you know, mixing the dancehall with the Afro beats, how did that link up happen?
Well, me and Burna have been like texting each other from a taller time about doing music and thing, you know, because we are both fan of each other's music. And I remember Berna linked me and said he was doing an album, you know, and he wanted some vibe, you know, so I sent him like 3 songs. And him same like the Tony and sing one. Mm-hmm. So he took that one for his album, and then I'd add this song, this Abubia song, and I sent it to him and told him, yo, I think this would go crazy if me and you do a thing on this one, you know? And he said, oh, this song is sick, bro. So he was like, he was saying, yo, I think I should put this one on my album, you know, but him actually fall in love with the Tony and sing one, you yeah. know, so. And that song is a banger as well. Big up Tony and sing too. Get everything like. Jaja God.
Jaja God.
Yeah, but me and Bern have a proper chemistry, and me and him par, me and him hang out, you know. He's a you with good energy and good vibes. Me and him born the same month to July, so.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? And rup. Bern is a God-fearing youth to him. Love him mother to just like me, so.
Oh, my gosh, yeah.
We have enough things in common, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. But me not have the locks then.
Yeah. Anytime you're ready, what?
Yeah, man.
Okay, so you also have Tony and Singh on the album.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. On the light that. Yeah. So you have Tony and Singh on the album as well. So let's, you know, I'm just gonna talk it straight. Let's talk about the friendship and the professional working together on music. What's the story with Tony and Singh?
Well, she's a very talented human
then
being.
Then we
don't
see
that, man.
We see that.
And me have endorse it. You know, she's from St. Thomas. Me and Tony and basically is from the same place. You know, so I saw her talent from a taller time. From she was Miss World, but she couldn't really do music like that while she was Miss World. You know, so I was just waiting on her to. You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
You know we ain't playing. You know they gotta bring my money and crane. Yeah, so I was like, me and Tony and I have like 4 songs to write now.
Okay.
And she's working on her EP at the moment and to share with the world because she's really talented. I'm very excited for her too, you know. And she's a beautiful soul. That is it.
What was that?
I'll sing the things them tonight.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I want to ask you because, you know, so far you've been sharing your journey from the early days, from the scheme to the dream. Can I rhyme to you? No. Go ahead. Right?
Yeah, so, bud.
From the scheme to the dream. And I'm wondering, how much do you love traveling? Because it seems like when you're in London, you're having a great time. When you're in Ghana, you're having a great time. Where the next place? Zambia? No, what next place you go to Africa?
We bring the vibe anywhere we go, bro.
Anywhere we go.
But yeah, I just mean that.
Okay.
Yeah,
do you have a
full
favorite
of energy?
Do you have a favorite city outside of St. Thomas?
You want people to eat me, brother? Me
no, no, no one, I love you.
Me have every city I'm a favorite, yeah?
Very professional, very good diplomatic answer.
Yeah. I have people that love popcorn in every city, so I love every city, bro.
Fair enough.
Yeah, that is it.
Fair enough. All right, so this is what I want to do. 2016, something happens that I only dreamt of as a kid. So as a kid who feels like, you know, you just feel like you are hip-hop. There's a lot of people that say, I am hip-hop. I feel like I am hip-hop. But I also feel like I am dancehall at the same time. Like, that's my upbringing, dancehall and hip-hop. So when I see PopCon signed to OVO Sound, that meant the world to me because I'm seeing something happen that I've only dreamt of, to see the wickedest artist in Jamaica signed to the wickedest label on this side. What did it mean to you at the time, and how did that link up happen?
Well, it's a link up where I'm through music, you know, just I'm naturally, you know, because I remember when I sing Only Man She Want, my friends were showing me like, yo, Drake tweeting their music, you know, so then I did the fix tape, yeah, I changed mixtape, yeah, and the man them rinsed the mixtape there for me, you know what I'm saying? And then I had a concert here. It was my first time here. And then Drizzy invited me to him OVO Fest and then an after party. And that's where the whole family start off, you know what I'm saying? And then Neeks forward at Jamaica and create the 6 in the 876.
Mad.
Where he's a, it's a whole different thing now, you know, him show the lifestyle and like, all we live in Jamaica, you know, because all we live in Jamaica is a movie. You know what I'm saying? So, with the chemistry and the relationship we built over all these years, it was only right that I signed to OVO, you know? Mm-hmm. Yeah. A lot of different labels tried to sign me, but I think you would be right to go with OVO. Because family first, right?
Family first, that is
that
it.
That is it.
That is it. And then now, from then till now, you know, we've seen the chemistry and the respect between you and Drake. How was it filming the video in Turks? Mud.
Yeah, his vibes.
Yeah.
Yeah, his natural vibes, you know. Because Turks, you know, when you reach a Turks, I'll be in trouble. Yeah, so it's just vibes. Yeah. And it was the family, it was Theo that shot the video, and big respect to Theo, same way.
Yeah.
I'm glad that me and Theo finally get to do something special, you know what I'm saying? Because we've been talking about it as well.
Big shout out to Theo Scudro,
yeah,
for sure.
Yeah, 100%.
So, I want to think about this for a second. So, we've got a room full of young talent. You know, your journey, like you said, is a dream come true. If you have a bit of advice for some young talent, whether it's a producer, artist, or anybody involved in the arts, or just even as a young person growing up in these times, any advice for them?
Well, my advice is you have to believe it, you know? You have to believe it before anyone else does. Because, and I'm saying this from my experience, not everyone is like popcorn, you know? I'm very optimistic. Believe in myself a lot. I see it before it happen. I deal with the laws of attraction. So I attract what I want to myself, you know. And I attract blessings and good living. I attract millions and billions to myself. You know
talk,
what I'm saying?
No, talk it.
That is it. So you have to speak it into being and you have to believe it. And you'll see it happen in a flash. Believe me. Yeah.
Jah works. One of the questions we were thinking about was, at this point in your career, things are going great. Is there something that you haven't done yet that you really want to achieve?
I don't want to achieve it. I want to go to America, bro. Yeah, I've never been to America before, so I think it's time to go now.
It's
you
time.
You know what I'm saying? So,
it's time.
Yeah, that's what I want to do right now.
For sure.
And I'm going on a world tour next. Yeah, that is it. We're doing it for dancehall, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, not just for popcorn as a person, you know, for the whole industry and for the culture.
For sure.
And for Jamaica, you know what I'm saying?
For sure.
That is it.
I mean, when you think about the size of the island of Jamaica, and the impact that our little island has on the world.
Jamaica Island, big still in her brother.
I true. Because she out to fight me right now.
Yeah, man, it's a big island still. It's bigger than enough of the island them too.
I true, what? All right, yeah. So our big island.
We little, but we tall, our.
All right.
That we do.
That we do, I try.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
And then you can find a Jamaican in every area code, in a brother.
That true?
What you mean?
What, is there any Jamaicans in here?
Brother, Jamaican there everywhere, my fam.
That true, boy.
Sometimes I wonder, oh, it's enough.
Yo, I promise you, I don't think I've ever been anywhere in the world that I didn't find a Jamaican.
Yeah, bro, my got a lot of places in the world, and I see Jamaicans everywhere. Man, I say, yo, Popcorn, what you deal with? Man, I say, oh, I wanna with this now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Also, we were talking about growing up in the church, singing in the choir, and then that love for the dance hall, and then here we are.
Singing in the choir, watching Lizzie McGuire, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that is it. you also mentioned, I think it was Grandma Gwyneth who wrote the scripts and you would act them out. So is there a potential acting future, films, movies, TV shows for the skull?
Yeah, definitely. And then we'll say, how many of them saw us up?
Oh, true, man.
You're one. Yeah, man. I mean, I love that too, you know. I really want to expand my talent in acting after a time.
For sure.
Yeah, I think I have that naturally. Right, Mr. Morgan?
The darling.
Yeah.
And then, I'm going to ask you a question that hopefully can be helpful to our audience as well. Obviously, like you said, no matter how much money you have, there's always going to be struggles. And that is something that's constant along the journey. So no matter when you're young, you're old, there's always going to be a challenge. That's life. Is there a way that you approach challenges that you can share with our audience? So whether it's, you know, creative block or finances or life is just tough, family is annoying, whatever it is. Is there something that you've learned over the years to approach challenges?
Well, with me, it probably will be different for other people because I approach my challenge with music. Hmm. Because music is my therapy, you know? If I'm going through something, I'm just going to sing about it and I'm good. You know what I'm saying? But I think you should just don't feed into it too much if it's negativity, you know what I'm saying? Because once you feed into it too much, it will automatically devour you. So you have to try to keep your mind positive in every challenge. You know what I'm saying?
For sure.
Yeah.
100%. So I guess right now what I'm doing is making the connections from the early days to now, right? Are you still playing the keys?
Yeah, I still play.
And is that still how, like, the process for creating your lyrics?
No, I don't play that as much now.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it's just something you do for fun or whatever.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So world tour. I'm trying to figure out what's next. So this tonight is the album drops, and then what's next? It's the world tour. What else?
Yeah, definitely a world tour and a next album. ASAP.
One time.
Yeah, because, you know, as Big Bro said, we can't done.
Hey.
Yeah, we have so much work to do, you know, mm-hmm. And not stopping no time soon.
That is it.
Yeah, forever.
All right, so, and then again, this question is going to be to you, but also for the crowd. In terms of inspiration, because obviously creativity is you know, it's got to be inspired by something. What is that for you? What is that biggest inspiration? What keeps you going? Because you're traveling, you're going from different climates. Yes, I mean, 2 days ago it was hot. Yes, yesterday on your Instagram story, you looked at the car with the snow. You said, "Jaja, God, what is?"
Yo, we can't bother with the snow, Kelly. Yeah, we can't bother with the cold, fam. But, you know, the work have to get done, you know. So, mm-hmm. I mean, life is my inspiration, man. That's why I love to travel, because I get a lot of inspiration from traveling, you know, and learning about different culture and meeting different people, you know. It's a balance with traveling. I travel to different places and then I go to Jamaica and I create there, you know what I'm saying? Yeah.
Sure. All right, last thing I'm going to ask you. Mm-hmm. You love to cook, no?
Yeah, nigga.
Yeah. So, is there anything that you would, is that something that you just leave sacred to you in the privacy of your, you know, in your own space, private time, downtime? Or is it something that, oh, Lord, I almost made it out safely. Almost made it out safely, Lord have mercy, man. Or is that something that you would pursue, like a little YouTube show or a Netflix series where Popcorn is chefing up?
Yeah, I would do a Netflix series, chefing up, every day.
Every day.
Because I love to cook so much, bro. You know?
Always,
I'll cook for everyone in here right now.
Serious?
Yeah, big, big cooking, fam. I do this for real, bro. What you mean? Just send in a request, and it's done.
All right, so we...
But me not make no popcorn, though.
No popcorn?
No. No popcorn.
No popcorn.
Popcorn only.
Popcorn alone.
That is it.
That is it, family. All right, so let's start. Tonight, the album drops at midnight. Popcorn is here. We're talking to him live, hearing about the journey from the dream. No, I messed it up. From the scheme to the dream. That is it. Listen, I just want to say thank you. I want to say congratulations.
Love, brother.
And because I know that it means something to you, the same way it means to me, God bless you and go with you and just continue to rock out.
I appreciate it.
Love and respect, my brother. Love.
T-Rex.
That is it. That
my
is
brother.
It.
Thanks, everybody. Have a lovely night. Oi, oi.
Yeah. Toronto, show some love, make some noise for Popcorn!